Okay, now let's dive into the EM algorithm. You already know how to generate data from the true model. Now let's use the expectation maximization algorithm to learn the model parameters from data. Let me first briefly review the EM algorithm. Suppose we have a model with latent variables x and observable variables y, and our goal is to maximize the observed data log likelihood, seeing y. However, that's not feasible since we need to integrate out all the latent variable x, and the time complexity will be exponential in the dimension of x. What we do in EM is repeatedly applying the expectation step followed by a maximization step. In the E step, we infer the posterior over latent states x based on current parameters and data. Then we fix this posterior distribution of x in the later M step. This means that the theta m is viewed as constant rather than parameter and will not be updated later in the m step. So in the m step, instead of maximizing the data log likelihood, we maximize the so-called expected complete log likelihood, or ECLL, under the posterior we just got from the e step. It can be proven that the ECLL is actually a lower bound of the data log likelihood, and they agree with each other at theta n, as shown here. So intuitively, you can see that a full EM cycle will never decrease and usually will increase the data log likelihood. In hidden Markov model, the E step is called the forward-backward algorithm. We define the forward probability AI at t as the joint probability of xt and all current and past data. It can be calculated recursively from the head of the chain to the end using this formula. The backward probability bi at t is defined as the likelihood of seeing all future data given the current state. And we have a similar recursion of bi from the end of the chain to the beginning. So combining future, current, and past data, we are able to calculate the singleton marginal probability of xt given all data, which is gamma, and the pairwise marginal probability of adjacent state, psi, with forward and backward probabilities. The data likelihood is given by the summation of forward probabilities in all states after seeing all the data, which is kind of intuitive. The m step of this hidden Markov model can be calculated analytically in closed form. Let's have a look. First, the new transition matrix A and initial probabilities psi are given by their empirical values from data. For example, the new transition probability from state I to state J is the number of times that state I switches to state J inferred from data and normalized by the total time spent in state I. The new initial probabilities are simply the average of each state at time one across all trials. Similarly, the new firing rate for a cell C can be calculated as the expected spike counts in state I, normalized by the total time in state I. One important property of degeneracy for latent state models like hidden Markov model is that there is no way to learn which is the first state and which is the second. As displayed here, these two permutations actually represent the same Markov model. In fact, we don't really need to order the states in hidden Markov model, but ordered array is more convenient to work with than a set when programming. So after learning, although we've recovered all the parameters, the order of the latent states may not match the true order, and we need to additionally sort the latent states to match the true ones for visualization. This can be done by comparing the values of learned firing rates and the true firing rates.